Hello, dear students. I am Dr. Shikha Pandey, Associate Professor from the Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. So today I am going to discuss about the threats to biodiversity, like habitat loss, poaching of wildlife, human-wildlife conflict. This topic is from the module 3, that is biodiversity. So now let's start this lecture with the basics of biodiversity. As we know that biodiversity means diversity of biotic life that is present on the earth. And India is having a very rich diversity because India is having a 10 biogeographical zone is there in India, and India is a mega biodiversity zone also. And India is having a 3 biotic hotspots among global 35 hotspots. 3 is only present in India. So with diverse hotspot, with diverse mega biodiversity nation and rich biodiversity of India, India is having threats to biodiversity also because man has begun to overuse or misuse most of these natural resources. Due to that unsustainable resource use, one productive forest and grassland now has been turned into the desert and wasteland, and that have increased all over the world. What is happening due to the unsustainable use of natural resources? Because man is starting to overutilize all the natural resources from the earth, and due to this overutilization of natural resources and over exploitation of natural resources, that threat has been arise due to because once that land is for agriculture purpose, now it has been turned into a desert and wasteland that has been increasing all over the world. And due to this, extinction or elimination of a species is a natural process of evolution, but the process of extinction has become particularly fast in the recent year of due to of human civilization. This because extinction is a normal process, as we also know, because evolution needs for the process of extinction, because if extinction will occur, then the new species will come. But due to this overutilization of natural resources and unsustainable use of natural resources, extinction rate was high in today's world, because due to the overutilization of this natural resources and pollution and habitat destruction and loss of habitat, poaching of wild animal, loss of wildlife, this will cause the extinction rate very high. This will cause the threat to the biodiversity, and due to this threat, the number is going to be reduced, and this threat is very, we need to study this threat, because if that speed of extinction is going on, this will cause very much harm to the environment, because every species is connected with each other in each and ecosystem. All species are interrelated on each other and they are interdependent. But if one species will be going to be extinct, then this will be harm to the new species also. So now comes to the next point. There is a loss or threat to biodiversity because of several reasons. It includes primary change in abiotic and biotic factors of an ecosystem that will be harmful effect on the biodiversity. So there is a loss of and threats to biodiversity because of several reasons. Many reasons is there for this threat of biodiversity, and it includes primary change in biotic and if there are numerous reasons for the loss of biodiversity, and the primary change in biotic and abiotic factors of an ecosystem that causes harmful effects on the biodiversity. So this is all about the threats to biodiversity, means why these threats are there for the biodiversity, because biodiversity is very important thing for today's world. So many threats to the biodiversity also. Due to the threats, it is going to be extinct one day, and it will be very harmful for our biodiversity. And due to over-civilization, human civilization, and the use of unsustainable manner of biotic resources, this threat will occur for the vanished, and one day it will going to vanish all the natural resources. And now comes to the definition of threats. Like this threats is of two type. First one is the anthropogenic causes, and second one is natural. Anthropogenic is nothing, that means man-made. Means those threat that is the man-made. This is anthropogenic, and then natural. Natural. So first one we will discuss about the man-made causes of threats to biodiversity. Means those threats that will originated by the activity of man, human activity. Like human activity. is caused due to human activity. So example for these anthropogenic causes are, first one is the loss of habitat. This is due to the human civilization, human urbanization. Now next is the poaching, that is about the hunting of animal, for their tusk, for their skin, for their meat purpose also, for the smuggling purpose also. So now next is the man-animal conflict. Man and wildlife conflict. This is a very common topic and this is a very interesting topic, as because man is starting civilization to forest also, they are going to be destructing the forest, and due to that destruction, animal will come into the man area and man will go going to the animal area. So some conflict will occur due to this man and human, man and animal interaction. Now next is the introduction of some exotic species. Exotic species is the alien species, means species that is not from that particular environment. So this is called as exotic species, invasive species, and alien species, or any name you can call it as. Now next is the global warming and climate change. This is all about pollution and global warming and climate change. Due to pollution, some species is going to be lost. Some there is a threat to biodiversity, because pollution will causes destruction to their flood into their territory. Sometimes very drought to that area. Sometimes too much flood at to their ecosystem. This will causing harm to the that particular species, and this will lead to the extinction and threats to biodiversity. This is all about the anthropogenic causes of loss of biodiversity. This is all anthropogenic causes, means human made, means human activity, means all are originated due to the human activity and human behavior. Now next cause is the natural causes. Natural causes that will causes naturally. First one is the narrow geographical area. Like narrow geographical area means any species have their very narrow area of their breeding. So that is also a cause of extinction. Next one is the low population. If any species is having a very less number of population, this will cause extinction of that species, because they have a very low population, they have very low breeding rate, and they have very low geographical area. So due to all these low areas, low breeding rate and low productivity, then obviously species size is less, and that will cause extinction of that species. And next is the natural disaster. Natural disaster is nothing but the natural disaster, like volcanic eruption, like any naturally caused disaster is there, and this will cause a vanish of any species, and this will cause originating on new species also. So these are the natural causes, and this is the anthropogenic causes. Natural causes will happen after some time. It will happen at the rate of naturally. So that is not that much of the concern, but anthropogenic causes they're having high concern, because this is due to human activity, human behavior, and human civilization. So we have to study these anthropogenic causes for the loss of biodiversity, because these are all activity that is originated due to the behavior of a human being. Now comes to the next slide. We will discuss about the next topic, that is about the loss of habitat, means habitat destruction. Why this loss of habitat is there? So what does it mean of loss of habitat of a biodiversity? So destruction and loss of habitat, natural habitat, is the main reason for the biodiversity loss. Natural loss of habitat and destruction of habitat is the main largest single reason for the causes of biodiversity loss. Now next point is that the billions of hectares of forest and grassland have been cleared over the past 10,000 years for conversion into agriculture land, pasture, settlement area, or development project. All these comes under the human activity. And this is all due to this is anthropogenic causes. So what will happen, like sometimes hectare of land is there and grassland are there, and this has been cleared from past 10,000 years for the conversion into agriculture land, pasture land, settlement area, and development projects. So after the conversion of all these hectares of land, that will be a destruction of habitat for important species. So where will that species will go? That will enter into the human territory and harm the human bodies also. And this will come under the human man-animal conflict. Next is the loss of habitat to grazing lands, industry, roads, and cities. Lots of habitats in the grazing lands, industries, road, and cities. due to that, loss of habitat is also there due to the development of lands, industries, roads and cities. And due to the habitat loss, this will lead to the formation of isolated, small and scattered population of that particular species. So it will lead to the formation of isolated, small, scattered population of that particular species. So due to that isolated, small, scattered population, their number is automatically going to be reduced. And due to this reduction, the extinction of that particular species, the extinction rate and the habitat loss of habitat and their threat is increased. Because of that human habitat loss, due to habitat loss, their population is going to be scattered. They have been isolated and they have been small. And this will causes the extinction rate very high. This will causes that species comes under the area of endangered species or vulnerable species. And next point is that is the small population are increasing. Same thing, increasing vulnerable to inbreeding, which causes loss of gene pool, high infant mortality and susceptibility to environmental change, which all may lead to the extinction of the species. So, due to that isolated, small and scattered population, this population are increasing vulnerable to inbreeding. That causes loss of gene pool, high infant mortality and susceptible to environmental change, which all may lead to the extinction of the species. So in this lecture, what we have discussed about that is like this loss of habitat is due to the anthropogenic cause, and this is due to the human behavior, human activity. And due to this loss of habitat, species habitat has been lost and they have been isolated, they has been scattered, they has been small. And due to this, their breeding rate is also decreases because of gene pool and mortality and infant mortality and susceptibility to environmental change occurs. And this may be lead to extinction of that particular species. So loss of habitat and habitat destruction is the main reason and the important reason for the threats to biodiversity. Now comes to the next slide. This is all about the loss of habitat. It is due to the human behavior, rapid human growth that contribute to global destruction of biodiversity. And the other important factor, first one is the human behavior and human global destruction of biodiversity. And next one is that loss of habitat is the deforestation. Deforestation is a destruction of forest area of any particular species. Now destruction of wetland for the development process, for the industrial process, for anything. Overgrazing by the livestock, overgrazing by any cattle will causes this loss of habitat and habitat destruction. Next one is the urban development of any particular area. This will loss the habitat of any particular species. Next one is what the building of dams. Next is mining activity. Next is landslides, and next one is the poor agriculture practices, and next one is the industrial waste. Dumping of industrial waste is also causing the habitat loss, because dumping of industrial waste, this will destruct that particular area, and due to destruction of that particular area, species will go vanished, and this is also a reason for the extinction of the species. So due to the loss of habitat, what about the reasons for loss of habitat? So first one is the deforestation and destruction of wetlands, overgrazing, urban development, building of dams, mining activity, bad agriculture practices and dumping of industrial waste. These are the reasons for the loss of habitats, and all are due to human activity, human civilization, human behavior. So it comes under the anthropogenic causes, and it is all due to unsustainable use of this biodiversity. So this unsustainable use of biodiversity and overutilization of this biodiversity, this will cause, and this will going to be harm very much, because this will lead to the extinction of the species. This will lead to the vulnerability of a species. One day that species will go vulnerable, because if any species habitat destruction is there, if their habitat is lost, so they will be automatically, their population will be go scattered and they will be isolated, and due to that their infant mortality rate is high and their struggle for existence is high, and due to that then that species may be going to be extinct. So this is the main reason for the threats to biodiversity. Now comes to the next thing. This is about like, it will reduce the biodiversity. The habitat fragmentation causes a reduction in the biodiversity because many animals like bears and large cats require large territories to substitute. So like some many animals like large cats like cheetah and some bears needs very large territory to exist or sustain to do in their breeding activity and all activity. And we already know Indian cheetah is an extinct animal due to that habitat destruction. Only reason for the extinction of Indian cheetah is the habitat destruction. So some forest bird reproduce only in deep forest or habitat far from human settlement. Some forest bird reproduce only in deep forest or habitat far from human settlement. A large island, like for example, can support more individual of given species and therefore less likely to suffer extinction due to genetic problem and a natural catastrophe. So, Indian cheetah is the example of extinction due to habitat loss. Extinction due to habitat loss because it needs very large territory to reproduce, to sustain or to live. So due to that, Indian cheetah or Asiatic cheetah has extinct due to this habitat destruction. So this is the main very important point about the habitat destruction. Like Indian cheetah is extinct today's date due to this habitat destruction. And some birds that will reproduce only in the deep forest or habitat that is far, very far from the human settlement area, because they will be going to disturb due to that human activity. And a large island like can support more individual of a given species, therefore less likely to suffer extinction due to genetic problem and natural catastrophe. And the one more example of this loss of species extinction, this is loss of habitat, is the dodo bird. Dodo bird is also extinct due to human settlement into the Mauritius Island. And they has been extinct due to the human activity, due to the human anthropogenic activity. Now comes to the next reason, that is what poaching of wildlife. Poaching of wildlife is nothing but the, is a very, also a very serious problem for the India, for the habitat, for the threats to biodiversity. Poaching is also a very serious threats to biodiversity. So poaching is nothing but the illegal trade of wildlife products by killing prohibited endangered animals. Like as for example, poaching is another threat to wildlife. Because why this poaching will occur? This poaching, what is the reason behind that poaching? The reason for the poaching is that they has been hunting animals for their various valuable body parts, like illegal trade of their skin, tusk, hair and horn. Many animals fall prey to various traps. International market is very high for this animal smuggling, and the common is a very important is a Tibet and China. Tibet market in China is a very important, very very highly they are doing a smuggling of these animal trades and animal skins. Now the what is a common, very common, very demanding animal related articles are tiger skin and elephant tusk are very high demanding articles around these days, because these human articles are very much demanding, and due for this, and they are getting illegal trade of skin and they are making lakhs of money. And this will be a very very dangerous cause. Now government has made many rules for the poaching of wildlife, for the hunting of any wildlife, and now the cost is very less for them. Now next is the why their poaching will do. They are doing poaching, the example for poaching is the skin and bones from the tiger. For this, due to this smuggling reason, the number of tiger has been reduced these days, because they are doing a smuggling of skin and bones from tigers. That's why tiger comes under the species of endangered species due to this illegal trade of their bones and skin. Now tusk from the elephant, that's why the government has launched Project Elephant to save these elephants, because they has been, due to this elephant number has been reduced very less, they are coming in the category of vulnerable categories. And horns from rhino and perfumes from the musk deer are extensively used abroad. That's why musk deer has been That's why musk deer number has been reduced and bears are killed for their gallbladder. So these are the very very serious crimes nowadays for the smuggling of animals and smuggling of their body parts for the money purpose. Now their number has been reduced, and due to that, and government has made many rules regarding that. Now comes to the next thing, that is about the CITES. CITES has been a international convention that is all related to the illegal trade of animal articles. So CITE, what does it mean? CITE means this is a convention on international trade in endangered species. International convention for the international trade of endangered species, and it has been comes under activity from the year 1975. This is an international convention that combine wildlife and trade themes with a legally binding instrument for achieving conservation and sustainable use of objectives. So that CITE will is an international convention that will combine the wildlife trade and themes, and that legally binding instrument for achieving conservation and sustainable use of objectives. The purpose of CITE is to ensure that wild flora and fauna in international trade are not exploited unsustainably. It should be not exploited. All the wild flora and fauna that comes under the category of international trade, which has been highly demanded in the international market, should not exploit and unsustainably use. CITE has listed 900 species that cannot be commercially traded as live specimen or wildlife product, as they are in danger of extinction. So CITES has come in the activity due to that endangered species area, because due to illegal hunting, illegal trade of animals, they are making very high money in the international market. But due to that endangered species, many species has been extinct. They has been come under the category of endangered, vulnerable. So that CITE will come in the activity in the 1975 area, and they have been made many rules for the international trade of animals and illegal trade of animals. Next is that CITE restricted trade of 2900 other species as they are endangered. CITE has restricted 2900 species that are comes in the category of endangered. So CITE is a very important, and it is an international treaty for the illegal trade of animal and their specimen. So now comes to the next slide, that is about the pollution. Pollution is also an anthropogenic causes for the extinction of species, because oil spill is in there in the oceans where a oil tanker is there, and some spill is there. That spill will causes harm to the many animal, that will destruct their habitat also, and that will causes some their, you can see in the picture, some grease will apply on the birds, and that bird will not be able to fly, and that bird will not be able to reproduce again. And biomagnification is again a reason for extinction of species, because biomagnification is the nothing but the magnification of chemicals in one tropic level to another tropic level. So if a little amount of DDT is in there in the water, this is going to be increased from one level to higher level, and in the higher level, like in animal level, it is very much. So this will cause harm to any particular species. Now plastic accumulation in the oceans, because too much plastic is there inside the ocean, that will destruct the marine ecosystem and marine life. And next is the noise and algal blooms and heat. Due to high heat, due to that algal bloom is there in the aquatic ecosystem, this algal bloom is causing very high number of nitrogen and potassium and phosphorus, and this will be very harmful for the organism, and this will be causing extinction of organism. This comes under the category of the endangered species. Next comes to the next reason for that habitat loss. This is about introduction of invasive species, like the addition of any new species. And what does it mean by invasion or alien species? Invasive species, alien species are those species which, when introduced into new area, causes biological invasion or extinction or introduction of an alien species. So that is a, now we'll discuss about that effect of that biological invasion, because it will harm the growth of that local species. Any local species is there, that will harm the growth of local species. And now entire population is wiped out due to the introduction of the alien species, introduction of any new species. And this will causes the increase the competition for resources. An example of invasive species are First one is the water hyacinth. Water hyacinth is a very common example. You can see easily in everywhere. It is a very important nuisance aquatic plant, because in India, it was introduced in 1886 in West Bengal as an ornamental plant. Since then, it has spread throughout India as an obnoxious aquatic weed that will covering a large area. So this water hyacinth, an aquatic plant, is introduced in India as an ornamental plant for the beautification of plant. But now it has been act as an invasive species, and this will be covering a very high area, and it is a very highly nuisance plant and aquatic weed covering a very large area and causing pollution to the aquatic pollution. This is the main reason for the aquatic pollution today's water hyacinth. You can see in everywhere, every water, every pond, and it is very nuisance because they are the new species in any area, and due to that new species, their predator is also not there. So if their predator is not there, then that number is automatically going to be increased. Their population size is going to be automatically increased. So this is the very important nuisance aquatic plant, and that weed will covering a very large area. Now comes to the next example, that is Parthenium histophora. Parthenium histophora is also known as weed grass, Congress weed, or weed grass, and anything their name is there. It has been introduced in India with food grain imported from US. It reproduced freely from seed and had spread in neglected area throughout the country, and its pollen also causes skin allergy. This is a very important aeroallergen, Parthenium histophora, and it is a very common weed you can see anywhere, because again, the problem is there, their predator is not there, so their number is going to be increased, and this is very high. Their pollens and their aeroallergen can travel in miles of the area, and they are very obnoxious and highly aeroallergen. That will cause very allergic to the any animal to us, and this is also again a invasive weed. Next is Prosopis juliflora. In the semi-arid part of India, has displaced other flora in the area of the area. It has become an invasive, seriously threatening the biodiversity. Prosopis juliflora is again a flora of the area, and it is also an invasive species, and it has become an invasive, seriously threatening the biodiversity. Now it is threatening the biodiversity, local biodiversity. So that introduction of invasive species causing threatening to the natural biodiversity of that particular area, because their predator is not there, and they are not added to any food chain or food web. So their number is going to be increased, and every time that is a very obnoxious to that particular area, and that will causes harm to that local species of that particular area. Now comes to the next thing for the anthropogenic, and this is also comes under the anthropogenic causes of threats to biodiversity. First one, now next one is the global warming and climate change. So when temperature increased in recent decades, certain species has begun breeding and migrating earlier than expected. So what will happen due to this global warming? Due to this increase in temperature, some species is breeding earlier than their natural processes. So other study found that the geographical range of a numerous species has shifted poleward or moved to a higher elevation, that indicating that some plants and animals are occupying area that were previously too cold for survival, and due to that decline in the breeding population also. So global warming and climate change will disturb the biological clock of any species, and due to this disturbance of biological clock, some extinction of species will occur, and this will cause a threat to that species. So what will happen when the temperature is increased, that particular species started breeding early, and due to that increase in temperature, they has been shifted to the higher elevation or moved to a higher elevation, because if any species of a North Pole is there, summer will increase and their temperature will increase, automatically they will migrate to that place where temperature was decreased. And that indicates some plants and animals are occupying the area that were previously too cold for survival. And due to that two cold places, their biological clock has been disturbed. Their breeding activity, their all activity has been disturbed. And due to all these things, their breeding population has been increased. And this is also a cause for extinction of a species. And that is also comes under the extinction of any species, because due to the change in temperature, due to the change in human elevation, due to the change in their behavior, they are going to shift any place where their activity, their breeding cannot be possible. Or sometimes due to increase in temperature, they can breed earlier. So this is very harmful for that particular species, for the survival of that species, and for the extinction of that, for the existence of any particular species in their natural habitat. So global warming and climate change is also a very important reason and for the threats of biodiversity. And it is also due to the human behavior and human activity. And it also comes under the category of anthropogenic resource, anthropogenic causes for the threats. Now comes to the coral bleaching. Coral bleaching is also due to the increasing global temperature and climate change. Because the increase in global temperature, their bleaching will cause, and the Great Reef Barrier along with the coast of Australia experienced bleaching events in the 1980, 82, 92, 94, 1998, 2002 and 2006. While most area covered with relatively low level of coral death, some locations suffered severe damage with a 90% mortality, and productivity is decreased or even eliminated in areas subject to dirt, sediment, lead and water. What will happen in the coral reef? Because due to increasing temperature, they need warmth condition. They need warm condition to survive and reproduce and to sustain. But due to increase in temperature, automatically they has been going to be declined, and there has been elimination, and it is subject to dirt, sediment, lead and water. And most of the area is covered with relatively low of coral death. Some locations suffered with severe damage due to this is the reason of Great Barrier Reef. This Great Barrier Reef, many times this coral bleaching will occur, and the year of 1980, 1982, 1992, 1994, 1998, 2002 and 2006, in all these years coral has been occurred due to the bleaching event. And now next come to the next reason. This is what next topic we are going to discuss, that is about the man wildlife conflict. Man is continuously interacting with different ecosystem for food, fuel, recreation, sports, urban development, waste disposal, etc. Like man is interacting with the animal for the purpose of food, fuel, recreation, sports, urban development, waste disposal. Every activity is responsible, directly or indirectly responsible, for disturbing species. So natural size of forests are reduced because of human encroachment. Therefore, animals often attacks on human society and create violence. When wildlife causes immense damage and danger to man, the conflict occur in retaliation. The village electrocute or kill the animal, which sometimes exceed poaching. What will happen due to this man-wildlife conflict? Man is interacting daily with the human, with the animals, because in the form of food, fuel, recreation, sports, urban development, waste disposal, etc. So this activity is responsible for disturbing that species directly or indirectly. That is disturbing that species. So natural size of forests are reducing because of human encroachment. Therefore, animal often attack on human society and create violence. Due to that human encroachment, animal often attacks on human society and create violence. When wildlife causes immense damage and danger to man, the conflict occurs in retaliation. The village electrocute or kill the animals, which sometimes exceeds to the poaching. This is also a reason for poaching. What will happen when the wildlife causes danger to human life, and when it will enter into the human territory, then villagers will kill or electrocute that animal, and it will comes under the category of poaching of animals. So this is a human and wildlife conflict, and this is all due to the threats of destruction of habitat, because habitat destruction will cause entry of any animal to human territory, and sometimes entry of human to animal area. And due to this interaction, man is going to kill that animal, and sometimes animal is going to kill the man. This is a very important reason. Next is that the dwindling of habitat, human encroachment into the forest area, and for reason for causes for this man-wildlife conflict. First one is the dwindling of habitat. Again is the habitat destruction and human encroachment into the forest area. And next is the wildlife corridor through which animal used to migrate seasonally has been used for human settlement and hence animal attack the settlements. Animal corridor in there is there in any seasonally and there has been used for human settlement and human attack the animal attacks the settlements. The stopping of cultivation of paddy, sugarcane, etc. within the centuries have led to animal to stray out. Stopping of cultivation of paddy and sugarcane within the century have led to animal to stray out. Sometime what will happen if human is going to be doing their cultivation of their paddy and sugarcane inside the forest. And for this, they are coming into the crop area and they are going to be stray out. And the compensation paid by government in lieu of the damage caused to the crop is not adequate and agonized. Farmer get revengeful and kill the wild animal. What will happen? The compensation provided for this crop destruction by the government is not satisfied by the farmer. And sometimes in to take revenge from the animal, the farmer is going to kill that animal. So this is also a human wildlife conflict. And usually the ill, weak and injured animal have a tendency to attack the man. So this man wildlife conflict is a very serious issue because sometimes human will going to enter into the animal territory and animal will come into the human territory. So man and conflict, man wildlife conflict leads to, first one is the crop damage, death of any animal. So if sometimes animal will enter into the villager area, villager is going to kill that animal. So this is again comes under the habitat loss and threats to biodiversity. And next is loss of human life. Sometimes loss of human life is also there. Injuries to the local people, injuries to the wildlife, livestock depredation, the reduction in the rate of livestock because they will harm anything. They will kill human. If any animal will enter the human territory, they are going to do anything, like they are going to kill any person, any animal, any their pet animals, their livestock. They will damage the crop. They will damage to the loss of human life. They will damage their property. They are going, animal can harm any way. So this is a very serious issue for human and wildlife conflict, and it can be lead to crop damage, animal death, loss of human life, injuries to people, injuries to wildlife, and stock depredation. Now comes to the next slide. This is about the example of that human and man wildlife conflict. So data from the Union Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change indicates that over 500 elephants were killed between 2014 and 15 and 2018-19, mostly due to human and elephant conflict. During the same period, 2361 people were killed due to the result of conflict with an elephant. So this is the data from the Union of Ministry and Environment, Forest and Climate Change. And this is indicates that over 500 elephants were killed in the year 2014 and 15 and 2018-19, mostly due to human-elephant conflict. During the same period, 2361 people were killed as a result of conflict with elephant. Next example is that total of 276 people were killed due to the human tiger conflict between 14 and 15 and 19 and 20. In Uttarakhand, Forest Department revealed that 56% of human deaths in man animal conflict in 2020 occurred in the last 4 months of the year. That has been reportedly 62 people died and 286 were injured in such incidents. So many people is also died and animal is also died in this man-wildlife conflict. Now comes to the next thing, that is about the example, that is solution to the man-wildlife conflict. So this is the moving from conflict to coexistence. The goal of human-wildlife conflict management should be to enhance the safety of people and wildlife and to create mutual benefits of coexistence. Next point is that integrated and holistic practice. Human-wildlife conflict management approaches allow species to survive in the area where they otherwise would have declined or become extinct. And all species on our planet also are essential for maintaining ecosystem health and function. Next is the participation. They allow full participation of local communities that can help reduce human-wildlife conflict and lead to coexistence between human and wildlife. So some participation of local communities should be there. Like this local community will suggest some way how to adjust with these wildlife. so that there will be coexistence between human and wildlife, and this will not cause any conflict or any danger in future. So there should be a participation with the local people, and moving from conflict to coexistence, integrated and holistic practices should be there to avoid this human wildlife conflict. This is about the solution of the conflict, and all species on our planet also is essential for maintaining ecosystem health and function. So they are also important. These wildlifes are also important. Now this is the and India faces an increasing challenge of human wildlife conflict, which is driven by development pressure and an increasing population, high demand for land and natural resources resulting in loss due to the high demand of natural resources that will resulting in loss, fragmentation and degradation of wildlife. And these pressure intensifies the interaction between people and wildlife because they often share living space without a clear demarcation of boundaries. So this man-wildlife conflict is also due to human high demand of land and natural resources that will resulting in loss and fragmentation and degradation of wildlife habitat. These pressures intensify the interaction between people and wildlife because they often share living space without a clear demarcation of boundaries. So this is all about the man and wildlife conflict solution. What India should do? What government should do? These pressure intensify the interaction between people and wildlife because they often share living space. So all due to this reason behind for this man wildlife conflict is more population. More population and demand of land and natural resource that will resulting in the loss and fragmentation and degradation of wildlife. This is all about the solution for man and wildlife conflict. Now, thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.